We were asked to determine the solution to the system of inequalities. The solution to a system of inequalities is a set of ordered pairs that satisfy all of the inequalities in the system. To indicate the solution to a system of inequalities, we graph the region on the coordinate plane that contains all the ordered pairs that again satisfy all of the inequalities in the system. To determine this region, we graph and shade the solution to each inequality in the system, and then determine the overlapping region of these solutions. Looking at the first inequality, because the inequality symbol is less than, the boundary line is going to be dashed. Whenever the inequality symbol is less than or greater than, the boundary line will always be dashed. A dashed boundary line indicates the ordered pairs of the points on the line are not part of the solution. Looking at the second compound inequality, notice how the inequality symbol is less than or equal to, which means the boundary lines are going to be solid. Whenever the inequality symbols are less than or equal to or greater than or equal to, the boundary line will be solid. A solid boundary line indicates the ordered pairs of the points on the line are part of the solution. Next, we will graph the solution to the first inequality. The first step in graphing the solution to 3x minus 2y less than 12 is to graph the dashed line given by 3x minus 2y equals 12. To graph this line, we could solve for y and put the equation in slope-intercept form, and then use the vertical intercept or y-intercept and slope to graph the line. But because the equation is in general form, instead, let's graph the line using the x and y-intercepts. To determine the y-intercept, we set x equal to 0 and solve for y. To determine the x-intercept, we set y equal to 0 and solve for x. Using the first row of the table, if we substitute 0 for x, we have the equation negative 2y equals 12. Dividing both sides by negative 2 and simplifying, we have y equals 12 divided by negative 2, which equals negative 6. The y-intercept is the ordered pair 0 comma negative 6. And now we will determine the x-intercept by setting y equal to 0. If we set y equal to 0, we would have the equation 3x equals 12. Dividing both sides by 3, simplifying, we have x equals 12 divided by 3, which is 4. The x-intercept is the ordered pair 4 comma 0. Let's go ahead and plot these two points on the coordinate plane and graph the dashed line. So 0 comma negative 6 is this point on the y-axis, and 4 comma 0 is this point on the x-axis. And now we'll graph a dashed line passing through these two points. And now the region that contains all the ordered pairs that satisfy this first inequality will be in this region on this side of the line, or in the region on this side of the line. To determine which region this is, we will select a test point and perform substitution into the original inequality. It's always easiest to select the origin unless the boundary line happens to pass through the origin. So for our test point, we'll use the origin of the ordered pair 0, 0. So using the ordered pair 0, 0, we substitute 0 for x and 0 for y into the original inequality, which gives us 3 times 0 minus 2 times 0 less than 12. Simplifying on the left, we have 0 minus 0, which equals 0. 0 less than 12 is true. So because this test point did satisfy the original inequality, this means all the ordered pairs on this side of the line will also satisfy the inequality, and therefore this region here would represent the solution to the first inequality. But because we have a system of inequalities and we're looking for an overlapping region, let's go and just draw arrows in this direction here, indicating this half plane represents the solution to the first inequality where the ordered pairs on the line are not part of the solution. And now we need to graph the solution to the compound inequality negative 3 less than or equal to y less than or equal to 2, which we can also read as y greater than or equal to negative 3 and y less than or equal to 2. Let's go ahead and break this inequality up into two inequalities connected with and. So again, this is the same as y greater than or equal to negative 3 and y less than or equal to 2. To graph the solution to this compound inequality, we begin by graphing the horizontal lines y equals negative 3 and y equals 2. The horizontal line y equals negative 3 is this horizontal line here, intersecting the y-axis at negative 3. Every point on this line does have a y-coordinate of negative 3. And again, because of the inequality symbol, we know both horizontal lines will be solid. Y equals 2 is this horizontal line here. And now we want to shade the region where y is greater than or equal to negative 3 and less than or equal to 2. Which means we would shade above y equals negative 3 and below y equals positive 2. If we wanted to, we can also select a test point. If we use the origin again, or the ordered pair 0, 0, notice how the y-coordinate is 0. Substituting 0 for y back into the original inequalities, we'd have 0 greater than or equal to negative 3 and 0 less than or equal to 2. Notice how both inequalities are true, verifying the solution to this compound inequality is the region between these two horizontal lines. And now to determine the solution to the system, we're looking for the region that satisfies both inequalities. So this would be the region between the two horizontal lines, as well as on this side of the dashed line, which means the solution to the system is this region here, also bounded by the dashed line here. Any ordered pair in this region will satisfy the first linear inequality as well as the second compound inequality. The ordered pairs of the points on the horizontal boundary lines are included in the solution, but the ordered pairs of the points on this dashed line are not part of the solution. I hope you found this helpful.